Good morning, Grove Park Gators. I am Amari. Today is February 28th, 2020. Please stand for the pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Please be seated. Gatorific congratulations to the following students who received positive referrals: Tori Jones, Megan Kelly, Brianna Nesmith, Jad Carter McCullough. Teachers, please allow these students to report to the main office for a prize. Congratulations to Tuesday's Math Madness winner, Miss Hope's homeroom. Awesome job! Come out and cheer our very one GPE track team on Saturday, March 7th. At Ridgeview High School. All track team members, please remember to arrive at the stadium at 7:30 a.m. The February morning mindset is we are connected. Our trait is respect. Great Gators are able to recognize the critical role others will play in their life and deliberately begin developing relationships that will help. Today we have a high of 63 and a low of 42 degrees. Our humidity is 40%. We can expect sunny skies today. For lunch today, we have a choice of popcorn chicken biscuit or tuna salad croissant. Now let's take a minute or two to learn something.
The clash between peaceful protest and violent resistance would produce images that caused the country to sit up and take notice. In New Orleans, on the morning of November 14, 1960, federal marshals escorted a six-year-old girl named Ruby Bridges to the local all-white elementary school.
I remember turning onto the street. I saw barricades and police officers and just people everywhere. When I saw all of that, I immediately thought that it was Mardi Gras. I had no idea that they were here to keep me out of the school.
Ruby, were you scared? I would have been terrified.
I wasn't, actually, because, you know, it's very hard for parents, I think, to explain to a six-year-old what was actually happening.
They didn't say, it's a white school, you're making history.
I remember them saying, Ruby, you're going to go to a new school today, and you better behave.
But Ruby was making history. 6 years earlier, after decades of struggle, the NAACP had won a major legal victory, Brown versus Board of Education, in which the Supreme Court declared that the doctrine of separate but equal schools was unconstitutional. But in many places, that triumph did not translate into change. For years after Brown, much of the South simply refused to integrate. Now, Ruby would be one of six New Orleans children chosen to desegregate several all-white elementary schools.
They were screaming and shouting and chanting 2, 4, 6, 8. We don't want to integrate.
The mothers of downtown New Orleans screaming at a Negro child as she entered the William Franz Elementary School, first in the city to be integrated.
Once I got into the school, all of these people here rushed inside of the building. They were taking out their children. Over 500 kids walked out of school that day.
What is your reaction to the court's decision continuing integration?
We don't want the niggas going in this school.
Well, it's
a white school.
They didn't see a child. They saw change in what they thought was being taken from them. They never saw a child.
Hey Gators, to celebrate Black History Month, we will close our show with some great musicians and influencers that have changed our world for the better. Remember, Grove Park Gators are respectful, responsible, and safe. Have a great day!
Get together and feel.